so what's up guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl mmj.co and I am back with another video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Y'all already know what it is. Don't forget to hit that notification bell button so y'all can know whenever I upload a video, because if y'all don't know when I upload a video, that means y'all are most definitely missing out. If you guys want to stay in tune with me and stay what I do in my daily life, follow me on my social media. I only do Instagram, and my Instagram is mmj.co. Y'all, don't forget the period is before the C and the O. So y'all, I just done revamped this wig, y'all, but look, it got a secret surprise up underneath the wig, y'all. Hold up. So I'm gonna be showing y'all a tutorial on how I dyed the underlayer of my wig. I most definitely revamped the old wig that I do not wear anymore. I feel like the way the hair, you know, trends are going on YouTube, I feel like a lot of people don't like show that it's okay to reuse the old wig and revamp it into something really cute instead of buying a brand new fresh wig. I think this wig was like a 26 inch body weight wig, and I cut it into a bob because I was like, okay, I'm bored, I want to do something else, I want to try something new. That's what I'm going to be showing y'all in today's video. Like, y'all, oh, y'all could whip up on somebody like,
who said something?
I did. So let's go ahead and get right on head into the video. Y'all, this is my wig that I've had for about a year, and I'm surprised that it still looks good. I really can't remember where I got the wig from, but the wig was bomb regardless. So I bone straightened the hair before cutting it so it can help me give more of a nice even cut, and I just went ahead and started cutting with my hair cutting shears. You want to be very careful and you want to take your time with this process because you don't want your wig to come out uneven. You want it to be cut thought, baby.
Purchase your tracks today.
So to help have more control of your cut, you're just going to want to use a comb and cut along the bottom line of where you have combed. If that makes sense, it's also me showing it in the video, and it helps you most definitely have more control of your cut, and it's also saving me a whole bunch of time when cutting this wig into a bob. So this is what the wig is looking like after I did the first cut. I tried it on and I noticed that there's a lot of longer pieces underneath, so I went back in and I cut some more, and I just made sure that it was as even as possible. Alright, so as y'all can see, I am now splitting the top from the bottom half of the wig. The bottom half is what I'm going to be dyeing. Make sure that you get a good amount of the bottom half because you still want that pink to show through and you don't want it to be completely hidden. This is what the wig looks like when I separated the top from the bottom. It's a little crooked, but you know, you don't even see that in the end at the end of the day.
Purchase your tracks today.
So I'm gonna be taking my BW2 powder and some 40 volume developer and some aluminum foil. That's just optional. I know a lot of people like using the blue powder, but this is just what I had to make some shake. So I'm gonna be taking about 3 to 4 scoops of the BW2 powder. I want a lot of the powder because I'm going to be making a big mixture. Then you want to just go ahead and just mix that mixture all together. You want to keep mixing and adding and mixing and adding until it comes out of the consistency of like pudding or icing. Please, y'all, use gloves when you are bleaching anything, because if not, your fingers are going to be most definitely burning. But I am just going ahead and I'm going to start bleaching the bottom half of my wig. And you want to make sure that you get every single strand when you are bleaching, because you're gonna be mad if you have a couple of brown and black spots after your bleaching job is done. You want to get in between, underneath, split open, and make sure you get up all of that. Then I'm going to be taking my aluminum foil and I'm just going to be adding that on top of this bleach section. Like I said, it's completely optional, but I decided to use aluminum foil to make the bleaching process go faster.
Purchase your tracks today.
Please make sure that you guys hit the temples with that bleach, because that is also very important. Then I let that bleach sit for about 30 minutes, and after that I took off the aluminum foil. I noticed that there were more brown spots than I would like, so I added more bleach and I let it sit for about another 20 more minutes. And then when that was done, I just rinsed all of the bleach out of the hair. Alright y'all, hear me out for a sec. I didn't use any shampoo because I didn't want to overload the hair with chemicals. Instead, I used a Shimmer Lights conditioner to help get rid of a lot of the yellow and brassy colors in the wig. And I let that sit for about 20 minutes and then I just went ahead and rinsed it out.
Purchase your tracks today.
Okay y'all, now we are finally getting to the fun part of the video. So I am just blow drying the hair just to make the process go a lot faster because I didn't have time to wait for it to dry. So this was the color that I used. I used the brand Adore and the color was Cotton Candy. And y'all, when I tell you, this is always my fun part, is just playing with color. So I just went ahead and I poured out a half a bottle, or you could use the whole entire bottle, it's a personal preference, into a mixing bowl. And y'all, when I was pouring this into the bowl, y'all, this dye looks like jello. It is such a pretty and a fun color. So I just went ahead and I started taking my dyeing brush and I just started applying that color all over the blind parts of the wig. And you want to make sure you have a comb so you can evenly comb through and distribute the color throughout all the strands of the hair. Just like when you're bleaching the hair, you're doing the same thing when you're dyeing the hair. You want to make sure you hit every single strand of hair.
Purchase your tracks today. Purchase your tracks today.
Thank you. once you have finished the dyeing process, you just want to set a shower cap over the dye just so it can, that's what the instructions were saying. I don't really know why, to be honest. But I just let that sit for about a good 15 to 20 minutes. And then after 15 to 20 minutes, I went ahead and I took that shower cap right off. So after I rinsed out the dye, I just let it dry overnight. And this is what the wig is looking like. Y'all, look how cute that color is. That is such a pretty color. Oh my goodness. So now I already installed the wig off camera, and pretty much what I'm going to do is just style the wig. If you guys want a video on how I install my wigs, go ahead and leave a comment down in the comment section below.
Purchase your tracks today.
So as you guys already know, you want to go ahead and get that hot comb so y'all can make sure that the hair is flat, y'all. And then I just went ahead and hot combed the front line of my wig so it can have some volume and so it can look a lot more natural in the front instead of it just laying flat and looking like a wig.
Purchase your tracks today.
All right, so it's time to do the edges, y'all. So I pretty much use any kind of mousse that I had on hand, and I'm just using my edge brush to do my edges. I'm not really doing a detailed edge job, mainly because of the way the bob is going to fall. You're really not going to see my edges anyway, but I just made sure a little something was done to them.
Purchase your tracks today.
Then I'm just going in and adding some finishing touches with my wax stick, and I'm just going to be putting some powder on my lace so it can blend a lot better. And that is pretty much it. So this, y'all, is the final result of what my hair looks like after it's styled and what it looks like after it's done. Y'all really can't see the pink, but I kind of like it because the pink turns out to be like a surprise. I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching this video. I hope that you guys try this style too, because I haven't seen this style in the wig community at all yet. I could be mistaken. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, please don't forget to hit that notification bell button so y'all can know whenever I upload a video. Also, make sure y'all follow me on my Instagram and my social media, which is mmj.co. Don't forget, the period is before the C and the O, okay? And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.